afternoon, everyone. Welcome to a special edition of Hardcore Challenge Live. It is our Hardcore Bowl 8 live broadcast coverage of Hardcore Bowl 8. We have Tom Mandick, owner of I'm Thinking RBs, division champ of the Great White North, facing off against Matt Heron, owner of the Beaver Street Roar, division champ of the Dirty South. Number one seed against number two seed. Number one in the league in scoring against number two in the league in scoring. It's looked like it was going to be these two all the way down, and it's ended up being these two. So here we are. Hardcore Bowl 8. Matt has never been there before. Matt only has one playoff win under his belt before this season. Tom has been there and is has more playoff experience in the Hardcore Challenge than anybody else ever in the league. He's had 6 total playoff appearances, 5 division titles, 2 previous Super Bowl appearances, and 1 league championship in 2010. So Tom has been there before, Matt has not. So there's the storyline. You've got very interesting lineup situations for both of them. It's week 17, so when you get to week 17, you don't know if the team that your guy's on is at the bottom, completely at the bottom, where the game just absolutely does not matter. They just don't want to risk it. He's got nothing to play for. They've got no contract incentives, nothing whatsoever. So how do they deal with those guys? And then you've got the other end of the spectrum, the guys that are absolutely have nothing to play for. Now in the AFC, there's really not a lot of those teams. Even the teams that have something to play for or are in the playoffs still have something to play for as far as seeding. However, it does not look like Beaver Street Roar is going to have one of their horses, Le'Veon Bell, as he is listed as inactive for the game. With the Steelers locked into the number 3 role, the team has decided to give certain players a breather in advance of the playoffs. Roethlisberger and Antonio Brown, as well as Le'Veon Bell, are all inactive for this week. It's been made official. He is IA for the week. So, Beaver Street Roars went out and picked up Drawn from San Francisco to fill the void. Sean Drawn. Interesting. Last week, he got 11 points, only 1 the week before that, and then 10 the week before that. He also has had a 10 and a 13, so 1, 2, 3, 4 out of the last 6 weeks, he has went double digits. So that may not be a bad pickup. You know, that the nice thing about being the Super Bowl team is you have the complete use of the waiver wire. It is at your disposal. There's nobody else fighting you for these players, so you have the opportunity to pretty much use at your discretion to fill holes with, you know, who might be that that hot diamond in the rough for the final week. So we're going to have quite a few owners on today. Got interviews scheduled throughout the early game. We're going to sit back and obviously watch as things unfold. We're going to see who the first person is that puts points on the board. Both guys got a lot of players going in the early games. You got DeMarco Murray for Beaver Street Roar going in the early games. You got Clay as tight end going in the early games. It's a little update on Clay. He is listed as active today against the Jets, so it's good news for Mr. Heron. He's not looking for a tight end. We've also got Mike Wallace going today. And joining us on the phone, we have one of the combatants in today's Hardcore Bowl 8. We have owner of I'm Thinking RBs, Mr. Tom Mandick. How are we doing today, Tom?
Good. Very good.
So, is your lineup done? Do you got your lineup all set? Are you ready to go?
It's all set and ready to go for sure. Yeah.
All right. He's all ready to go. So what's your when you're looking at your lineup coming into today? What's your biggest concern coming into the game today?
Lorenzo Alexander, maybe. Maybe he's the one that's not going to get me maybe 10 points. I don't know. I've got a pretty damn good lineup, I think. I got to do a shout-out for the Raiders for leaving Tom Brady active and keeping him in the thing. So, yeah. I'm looking at my team, and I'm quite happy with it. Could be week 14, could be week 10. This is the lineup I'd like to have, so.
Huh? I agree. Your team looks very, very strong coming in. I had a question on some of the guys and what they're how much they were going to play them, but it looks like your squad's pretty well suited up and ready to go. Is there any you have any big concerns when you're looking at your opponent, or are you just pretty much looking at is if your team does what they do, that's going to be all you need?
If my team does what it's been doing all year, I'm not concerned about the opponent type. Like I said, I wasn't afraid of anybody this year. I was going to bring it and let's go for it because my team has been on fire and scoring major points. So if I score 200 and somebody beats me, oh well, then kudos and they deserve it.
Absolutely. Well, you got a lot of guys going here in the early game, so I would guess right out of the gate here we're going to know, you know, how you stand, I would guess. Here within the first hour or two, you got Brady, you got McCoy going, you got T.Y. Hilton going, Ertz is going, Rodgers is going. I mean, most of your offense is going, plus three of your defenders. So, I mean, we're going to know real quick.
Sure. It's going to be an exciting morning for the first series of games here. And we should know by the end of the first games what's going to happen.
I would think so. I would think so. It's going to be interesting. Cam Newton's a big question mark for me on his team. I don't know what they're going to do with Cam. And him not having Le'Veon Bell, that really hurts. So.
Yeah, that's not very good. That's unfortunate for him that he got into that kind of a bad luck.
Yep, absolutely. So.
I know about it. It happened to me last year. So.
Yes, absolutely. It happens. So, do you have a prediction? I'm going to ask for a points. Points. Do you have a point score prediction for today's game? A winner and a point total.
182 to 136.
All right. I'm assuming that's you winning.
Oh, yes.
All right. Well, we will see. We will see. I'm going to, Tom, good luck today. We'll see if you can become the first in the league to ever win it twice. You got a hell of a chance to do her. That's for sure. Your team's been scoring all season. So thanks for taking some time. Good luck. Maybe, giving you a buzz later for a, victory speech, possibly. So we are now. There you heard from one of the opponents in Hardcore Bowl 8, Tom Mandick, owner of I'm Thinking Arby's, calling from north of the border in Canada, the Great White North, literally representing the Great White North Division. And now we have on the phone the other combatant in Hardcore Bowl 8. Representing the Dirty South Division, we have owner Matt Heron of the Beaver Street Roar. Good afternoon, Matt. How are we doing?
We're doing pretty good.
So, how are you feeling about looking at the lineups this morning? Obviously, you watched all the morning shows. You know who's playing. You know who's not. I'm sure your lineup's set. You're ready to go. How do you feel about it?
Well, I feel pretty good about my lineup. I have to admit that loss to Le'Veon Bell is definitely not a good thing. But, Sean Drone, I'm putting him in a PPR league. If he can do something similar to what he did just last week, then it might just give me, I just need 10, maybe 15 points, and hopefully that'll be enough.
4 out of the last 6 weeks, he's got double digits, so, you know, that's not bad.
Exactly.
But
so other than that, I do have word that Cam Newton is actually going to play most likely the entire game. Their backup, Anderson, is sick. So
there you go. It could be the – there you go. Because I had heard so many rumors about Cam. He was my big question mark for you this week, was what they were going to do with Cam.
Yeah. Well, just to back him up, I actually picked up EJ Emanuel.
I seen that. I saw that.
Yeah. Well, there's a chance. I know in the past, I think he has a touchdown to interception ratio of about 18 to 15, which doesn't sound very good at all. But at this time, Sammy Watkins is back and Charles Clay has been lighting it up. So there is a chance that he's going to put up good numbers, which would equal good numbers for Charles Clay for me. After my search for a tight end all season, I finally got one.
There you go. That's when it counts.
Yeah. So, hopefully. My odds, they're not in my favor. I am the underdog. But at the same time where I'm thinking RBs, I'm not afraid to say his team's name. It seems like he was. He could not say Beaver Street Lord, not once. But anyway, I'm thinking RBs. Yeah, they've been on a scoring tear all year. They got they're the highest scorer in the league. But the Beaver Street Roar, my team, we were the second highest scorer in the league. And it's not like I never visited 200 points, you know. So it looks like a lot of I've got quite a few players that are going in the later games this afternoon. So, it won't be all done until, you know, the last whistle was blown. So,
You got Burnett going tonight. So you're a pick six away, possibly, from who knows, at the last second of the game coming back and winning. It could come down to that. It's hard to tell.
Yeah. It seems like one or more of my defensive players has made a serious play that is, ended in lots of points. So if I can have maybe one or two of my defensive players hook up and score, like, I don't know, 20, 30, something like that. I've seen it happen. I've had it happen. Then I should be okay.
Yeah, it's possible. This is an interesting one. There's a lot of question marks. A lot of question marks. Because it's hard to tell. You know, because if New England comes out and they put it on Miami, I mean, I could totally see them pulling out Brady and try to cruise into the end. I don't know.
Oh yeah. Well, Tom Brady, he's been great for the whole season. But the thing is there's a chance they could get close to the end zone or what have you, and then all of a sudden it's LeGarrette Blount time, and then there's Tom Brady who's got a nice 180-yard half of passing, and no touchdowns, and they could still be up by 21 and still bench him in the second half. So. Yeah. I might be reaching, but there's a chance.
I picked you to win because, I want to see somebody in our damn division finally win it. So I'm hoping, but we'll see. It's going to be tough.
Looks like a couple people have picked me and I appreciate the votes of confidence there. Now I am up against the juggernaut.
This is true, man. He did set the league record this year in scoring, and I mean, it wasn't, his team has been killing it from start to finish. Even through the Brady suspension, he managed to keep winning.
But then again, there's got to be that 1 week, and I know he hasn't had that 1 week yet where he puts up a mortal score, so to speak, and it might just come in the last week of the season. So If that's the case, then I think I'm going to be holding up that hardcore cup, man.
All right. Well, do you have a prediction? Do you want to put a score to a prediction?
I'm going to say we're going to go about, let me do some quick mathing. yeah, I'm going to say, you know, when I look at his lineup really quick, T.Y. Hilton and Brandon Cooks, man, I mean, they could put up big points or no points at all. So with that in mind,
yeah, because both of their teams have nothing to play for. Both of their teams have nothing to play for. So those are two I was looking at too. Those they could get nothing today.
Yeah. So I'm going to say 165 to it's going to be a close one to about 150. And I'm going to pick myself to be the victor in the end.
All right. A 10-point victory.
I don't think anyone's going to have a 200-point.
15-point victory. Excuse me. 165 to 150. All right. We will see. Well, kickoff's 4 minutes away. We'll see who draws first blood. And we'll see. His like I said, his roster is mostly early game heavy. Your later game, yeah, you're about even. So
yeah, I'm about even.
It's gonna be I'd say by the end of the first game, we're gonna know whether you're looking good or you're might be needing to worry. One or the other.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I'll probably be talking to you later, either in concession speech or a victory speech, one or the other. So good luck. Good luck, and hopefully you can bring it home for the Dirty South.
Yep. Thank you very much, Ben. You're a great commissioner. This is a fantastic league. I just want to thank everyone that participates in this league for making it as good as it is. It's the most fun fantasy football league that I play in. It's been an outstanding season. The Dirty South represented. We had three teams in the playoff. We had just a winning record almost throughout. Like, I'm more than just happy to be here. I'm expecting to win. So let's have a good day. And I can't wait. So thanks again. Good luck, Tom. Not that you need it, but good luck. And let's bring it on home.
All right. Like I said, maybe we'll probably be talking to Matt later, either victory speech or concession speech, possibly an update if he wants to jump in between games. We are about 2 minutes now from kickoff of Hardcore Bowl 8. Ball will be in the air soon, and all of the early games that kick off at 1 p.m. It is currently 12:58, ticking down under 2 minutes to kickoff. You've got a lot of the big guns for RBs going early here. Tom Brady, LeSean McCoy, T.Y. Hilton, Zach Ertz, Jacquizz Rodgers, three of his defensive starters, all going in the early game. You're going to know right out of the gate here whether RBs is going to get it done. Are they going to be the one that puts the first points on the board? You would think. Are they going to be the first of Hardcore Bowl 8? We will see. Like I said, we're less 1 minute from kickoff. Hardcore Bowl 8. We got I'm Thinking RBs. Owner Tom Mandick, division champ of the Great White North, has won the Great White North for, this was his sixth straight division title. Tom lives north of the border in Canada. Will the Hardcore Cup leave the United States again? Or will it go? Remain in Iowa. It's currently in Iowa right now. It'd just be moving cities. Be moving to Des Moines. But it's currently in Iowa right now. Is it going to remain in Iowa? Or is it going north of the border? We're going to see. The games are all going live right now. It's 1 o'clock. All the 1 o'clock kickoffs are going to be happening. We've got game action getting ready. And Hardcore Bowl 8 is underway. Who's going to be the first to put points on the board? It's going to be very interesting, that's for sure. Like I said, RB's is roster heavy in the early games. Beaver Street Roar is pretty much even. They've even got one player playing in the late game. So there is a possibility that not until very late tonight till we see how Mr. Burnett, defensive back for the Packers, fares in his game. It could come down to him. Morgan Burnett. Could come down to Morgan Burnett. Wouldn't that be crazy? As time ticks away, a garbage ball's thrown up in the air. Morgan Burnett picks it off, returns it for a touchdown, gets the 6 points for the touchdown, gets like 6 points for the 60-yard return, ends up being like a 15-point play, and Matt wins. Wouldn't that be some shit? Probably not going to happen, but that would be crazy. But the possibility is out there, as there is one player on the roster playing in the late game today. Wow, we are waiting to see. He's a safety. Well, that is, safeties are good for them garbage time interceptions. So that could be good. Could be good stuff right there. That could be good stuff. So I'm saying, you never know. It could come down. It's hard to tell. It's hard to tell. I think you filled the Le'Veon Bell spot very well, Matt. I thought you filled that pretty well. I thought Drawn was a good pickup. I did kind of look at McFadden. I saw Tom grabbed him, but he's not 100% healthy. So, but I did think he was also a good pickup because the Cowboys are resting Zeke this week. So like I said, we have we've got several owners we're gonna have on the show tonight, today, tonight, this afternoon. Let's give out the call-in number. It's going to be open all show. Anybody that's out there, whether you're in the league or not, whether you just want to talk some football, it is football Sunday. You're sitting there watching your game. You just want to talk some football. Hey, we got time to fill. So if you feel like calling in, please feel free. I will throw up the call-in number periodically as the show goes on. And, you know, save it, write it down. It ain't going to change. He wants to call in. Hardcore Bowl 8 is underway. We've got guys on the field. Ball's in the air. Tom Brady is on the field. Looks like Patriots are possibly going to start with the ball first. We've got guys on the field. We've got DeMarco Murray starting off with -1 yards rushing. That's how you want to see him rolling. -1 yards rushing on the board for the Beaver Street Roar. That's not what you want to see. That's not what you want to see. Who's going to be the first points on the board? Neither of their defenses are going. Both of the defenses play in the later games, as you have RBs going with the Cardinals defense at the Rams today, and you got Matt with the Beaver Street Roar going with the Raiders at the Broncos. Gotta love the love for the silver and black. And I got a feeling the Raiders D is really gonna rise to the occasion and get some freaking turnovers today. I'm telling you, they got the Broncos offense is not strong. We beat them up the last two times we've played them. Beat them up bad. One of those games was the 5-sack game for Khalil Mack. So there's a definite possibility Mr. Heron gets them Khalil Mack points, and that defense of his could really get some points at Denver today. That's a put a star next to that one. There you go. Jacquizz Rodgers. The point has been broken. The point scoring has been broken.
Oh yeah!
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Point scoring has been broken. We've got one on the board. as I'm thinking RBs. 16 rush yard for Jacquizz Rodgers. He's on the board. He's on the board. Let's see. I want to see who's the one that's going to put the big first play on the board. McCoy also on the board. 3 rush yards and a reception for 6 yards thus far. There's some points. 2 points. Up to 2 points. RB's on the board. He's moving on up. Tom Brady's got 4 pass yards already. He's moving up as well. Keep a little eye on these bench guys. I'm curious as to see McFadden, because I think that could have been a guy Beaver Street Roar maybe should have picked up as and threw him on his bench as just a maybe. But we'll see. We'll see. Oh, Beaver Street Roar! It's on the board. They got a point. They are on the board. As 2-1. DeMarco Murray, 10 rushing yards. It's on the board. Our next interview that we're going to have on, just to throw a little tickler out there for you guys, we are going to have on who was the defending champ coming into the playoffs. The last champ, he currently holds the ownership of the Hardcore Cup, which our two owners are battling for today. We're going to have Kent Schmidt, owner of Bison Broncos, on at 1:15. He will be our next interview on, so make sure you stay tuned for that. 1:15, we are going to have Kent Schmidt, owner of the Bison Broncos, on. We'll see who he thinks is going. He's going to be handing the cup over to. He came in, he was looking strong, looked like he might have had a possibility to be the first two-time back-to-back champion, but did not hold true, did not hold true. Tom Brady with the 6 rushing yards. That's something you don't see every day on his stat line. You don't see him, Mr. Tom putting up the rushing yards. It's probably not something you don't want to see, quite frankly. It's probably something you don't want to see. So, for anybody just tuning in, it's Hardcore Bowl 8. We are 8 minutes into the game. Kickoff was at 1 o'clock of the early games. We've got an early 2-1 lead for, I'm thinking, RBs over the Beaver Street Roar, as they have stretched that to a 3-1 lead as Tom Brady picks up some more passing yards and grabs his first points of the game. So come on in. So, 3-1. Who is going to be the first guy to put the big touchdown on the board? Tom Brady moving the ball. He would have been my first guess if I had guessed somebody who's going to break it. And we're in the red zone. You've got Jacquizz Rodgers in the red zone right now. Red zone alert. Are they pulling him? Still 3-1. Not been as quick a start as I thought. I really thought I would see some big quick touchdowns, but points are starting to come on. Beaver Street Roars, first two defensive guys have taken the field. They're on the field. Ekiko Alonso and Rakpo on the field for the Beaver Street Roar. Like I said, at 1:15, we are going to have our current hardcore champion, Kent Schmidt, owner of Bison Broncos, on the phone. Going to talk about how his season went, how he felt about the way his season ended up, what he's looking forward to his draft strategy in the big 2017 draft, and what he thinks about the game and what's currently going on. You've got Tom Brady in the red zone, Patriots in the red zone. I'm thinking RBs, quarterback is in the red zone. First trip there for Tom Brady today. Does he come away with points? Is it going to be Tom first? It's looking like it. You got Alonzo. He's guarding the red zone down there as his team's in the red zone. So you got Matt's linebacker right now against the quarterback. So you got Beaver Street Roar. Two players. Oh, Ertz. Grabs a reception for 9 yards. Grabs a reception for 9 yards. And that is more points for RBs. Is it up 4-3? Oh, Rakpo with the tackle for Matt Heron. Beaver Street Roar. Oh, yes. I saw that, Matt. Oh, and there it is. Touchdown! Touchdown! There's the first score. In the Hardcore Bowl 8, it's Tom Brady. He's put 8 points on the board already as this 11-3 lead for the I'm Thinking RBs over the Beaver Street Roar. There it was. There it was.
Oh, yeah.
First score of the game. First score of the game. So, there you go. You heard the bell. It's a fight now. It's been broken open. You got Ertz up to 4 points now. Oh, oh. Got points are flying up there. RB's is up 14-3 now. They've already put an 11-point lead on. Here we go. Here we go. It's a game, boys and girls. We knew it was going to be a lot of scoring early as RB's, you know, they set the record for points scored in the Hardcore Challenge regular season this season. You knew it was going to be a lot of points getting scored, so knew it was going to be good. And it is looking like it's going to be, too. 14-3 thus far. Who's going to be the next points on the board? Alrighty. We're going to be having Kent Schmidt here on the phone soon. Owner of the Bison Broncos. They are the current Hardcore Challenge League champion. They are a 2015 champion. Current owner of the Hardcore Cup. Sitting in their living room right now. Kent had a solid season this season. Was in the playoffs, just did not advance on. So let's go to the phones right now. On the phone we have with us, owner of Bison Broncos, Kent Schmidt, our current champion. How are we doing today, Kent?
I'm good.
So
Happy New Year.
Yeah, Happy New Year to you too. Absolutely. Happy New Year to you and the whole family. Tell them I said hi. Oh, we just had some more points on the board for Arby's as they jumped up 14-6. Looks like Ertz is starting off. So, have you, I'm sure you've took a look at the matchup for today, Kent. If you had to pick a favorite, who would you be leaning towards projecting to win today?
I think it's Arby's. They just look like the stronger lineup. Brady going. I've sort of touched on already. I think he's going to put up a good game. Patriots need this game to secure the home field throughout. So I think they're going to put in a strong game. So I expect another maybe 2-3 touchdowns from Brady yet.
Absolutely. Because I thought it was interesting that, because I was curious as to what they were going to do with Brady and then coming down because, you know, the Raiders won the last game, so it kind of forced their hand that they really had to play him this week. I don't think they wanted to, but as we see on the other side of the ball here, live, we've got Carolina creeping into the red zone for the Beaver Street Roar. Interesting. Have to keep an eye on that. So, Kent, you did pretty well, you know, coming back to defend the cup this season. You made it into the playoffs. How do you feel about your season as a whole?
I thought it was pretty decent, especially starting off slow. I came on strong at the end, but wish I could have done a little better in the playoffs. I had a pretty terrible playoff game, but overall, though, I think I did pretty well.
Yeah, I think so. I would consider your season a great season. I mean, you were way down. You battled back. You made it into the playoffs. And, you know, what happened in the playoffs happens. And, it's happened to me before, too. So, what it is. So, when you're looking forward toward next season, obviously, it's a total reboot. You know, things are getting shuffled around. When you're looking at building your team, building the Bison Broncos for the future, what are you looking for in that first round? You going quarterback? You looking running back? What are you looking for that first piece of the puzzle?
What's one of, for me in the past is having a strong quarterback. I had Peyton Manning. I made it to 2 Super Bowls with him as my quarterback. So I think I really need to have a strong quarterback in there.
Yeah, can't go wrong with a quarterback. I agree. When I'm looking at next year, I know a lot of guys are probably thinking running back, but running back's huge, but they don't last that long. And if you could get that quarterback that you can have for 5 years, that would be huge. That's what I'm looking at. So, your prediction today is Arby's. If I put you down, is it you're predicting Arby's?
Yeah. To be quite honest, I think they might win pretty easily.
Yeah, they just jumped up to 17-4 as they just put some more points on the board. So they're early game heavy. So, all right. So, Kent, let's switch from fantasy football for a second because you know today's a big game. So, who are you picking? Who are you picking in the Raiders Broncos game? Do you think McGloin is going to have enough to push the Raiders past the Broncos? Do you think the Broncos, with nothing really to play for, are going to be able to take down the Raiders? What do you think?
Actually, they have a little something to play for. I heard Kubiak, this might be his last game coaching.
I seen that. That's probably strategic. Just they could make him have to play harder or something. Give him something to play for.
Yeah, and plus, Broncos like to finish with a winning record, 8-8 versus 9-7. That's it.
Yeah.
Big difference. So
should be a very interesting game with McGloin going, Carr's out. Raiders need this game bad so they can win the division. Either that or the Chiefs got to lose. It's a very interesting game. And
it'd be interesting to see what the Raiders do quarterback wise with the backup in there.
Yeah, I'm crossing my fingers. That's for sure. I'm going with McGloin, but what else can I do? I got to root for him. It's all we got right now. Although Carr surgery went well, so that's positive. But he ain't going to be back any second. So, all right. Well, Kent, where do you live, Kent? Is it Cedar Falls?
Yes, yes.
Cedar Falls. Okay, I thought so. So Cedar Falls is the current home of the Hardcore Cup. Does it move to Des Moines or does it move to Canada? That's the question. So, you know, might be making a short move. We'll see. Well, actually, it has to come by way of Florida. Either way, one's got to go by way of Florida, and then it comes back out. But all right. Well, Kent, thanks for taking some time to join us today. I appreciate it. Obviously, Kent's our current champion. He has what everybody's playing for today. So we will see if they can grasp what Kent has. As the points, they are flying up. It is 20-4 right now. As I'm thinking Arby's has stretched to a 16-point lead early here in Hardcore Bowl 8. It's going to be interesting. It's going to be interesting. 20-4. So, looks like the Panthers scored. Cam Newton did not get the touchdown. He only came with 1 point on that drive. It's not what Matt needs. He needs points every time Cam Newton's moving the ball down the field to keep pace with Brady, who's looking tight already today as he gets 41 passing yards, 6 rushing yards, and a touchdown, 8 points out of his first drive. That's what you want to see. You got Ertz with 6. You got Jacquizz Rodgers with 4. You got LeSean McCoy with 2. Everybody he's got out there is hitting so far, except for T.Y. Hilton, who's still sitting with the goose egg. Beaver Street Roar. You got Wallace, Mike Wallace, in the red zone. He needs some points. He needs some points. Beaver Street Roar needs somebody to make a big score. It's going to be interesting. Next owner we're going to have on for an interview is Corey Courtney, owner of Cheesehead. Came right down to the wire. Cheesehead actually ended with a winning season record this season. Had a winning season. They were in the fight down to the end. And Brady's back on the field. Brady's back on the field for RBs. You know, Cheesehead had a really good season. Did not make their first playoff appearance, but they've been an owner in the league since 2010. They're always competitive. They play hard. And I'm looking forward to picking their brain a little bit to see what they've got, what Corey has in plan for his 2017 draft, how he felt about his 2016 season, how it ended up, and get a little insight on how he feels about this game. We got another point there for the Beaver Street Roar as they close the gap there to 15. It's 20-5. I'm thinking Arby's is up. Arby's is up. Let's see here. Nobody's in the red zone right now. Tom Brady's on the field. Cam Newton's on the field. DeMarco Murray's on the field. Mike Wallace on the field. Bailey, kicker for Dallas, is on the field. Dallas is down 0-3. Throw it up there. Anybody wants to call in? Want to talk football? Want to talk fantasy football? Whatever. Phone lines are open. So we're going to carry our live Hardcore Bowl 8 broadcast, live coverage. We're going to carry it on through to the first game. At the end of quarter 3 of the first game, we will be cutting out our live studio coverage. I will be heading over to join the Florida Raider Nation at O'Brien's in Brandon, where we will be live streaming Super Bowl updates from the Florida Raider Nation, Broncos, Raiders, watch party. The game may be called there. We may be announcing a live winner there. Or we'll be doing it back here live in the studio directly after. Or if it's still close, we may not be able to announce a winner until later Sunday night, depending on what Mr. Burnett, safety for the Packers, does. We've got one guy going tonight. Brady's in the red zone again. We got, I'm thinking Arby's in the red zone again. Not good. Not good. As it's looking like the Patriots. Do we have another touchdown by Brady? Do we have another touchdown by Brady? Yes, we do. Oh, my. Arby's puts another points on the board, points on the board, as Tom Brady jumps up to 14 points already. Cam Newton has grabbed another point on the other side of the ball, as well as DeMarco Murray, as they have jumped up to 7, but it is currently a 26-7 lead for I'm Thinking Arby's in Hardcore Bowl 8. As they have Tom Brady's looked sharp thus far. He's got 2 passing touchdowns. And not looking good, folks. It's not looking good here out of the gate. Beaver Street Roar needs to see some points. Needs to see something out of Cam Newton. It's ticking down to late here in the first period. Cam Newton's got 2 points. He's got 52 passing yards, but he's got to see something out of Cam Newton. Got to see something out of Cam Newton. So as I said, at 1:30, our next owner we are going to have on for an interview is Corey Courtney, owner of Cheesehead, who will be joining us. We're going to go over how Corey feels about his season. He finished with a winning record, just missed the playoffs, but was very competitive this year, had a good season. Pick his brain a little about his 2017 draft strategy, how he feels about how this game's going, what his predictions are, and who he thinks is going to win. He will be our next owner on at 1:30. Throw the call-in number up there if anybody else wants to call in. Happy New Year. Thanks for joining us. 1-1, 2017, Hardcore Bowl 8. Here we are. Time to crown a new winner. Who is going to raise the Hardcore Cup this season? It was Bison Broncos last year, who was a second appearance in the Hardcore Cup. And they finally got it done. This season, who's it going to be? Who's it going to be? Still holding 27-7 now. More points go on the board for RBs. They're moving it on up a little bit. Beaver Street Roar. Oh, we got a bunch of guys on the field now. McCoy comes on the field. Hilton comes on the field. Jacquizz Rodgers comes on the field. Torrey Smith's on the field. Excuse me, not Torrey Smith. Smith, the linebacker for Jacksonville. We've got a very So, here we are. Well, Corey, it's... Of course it has commercial breaks. There will be commercial breaks. Of course there's commercial breaks. But not in the middle of the action when we got guys going and it's the first quarter of the Hardcore Bowl 8. And Corey, it's not like the radio. You can't listen to yourself on the radio while you're talking. So I don't need you to be watching while you're talking. You can figure out your viewing after I talk to you. So... we're going to go to the phone lines here, where our next guest we have on is Corey Courtney, owner of Cheesehead. Corey, how's it going?
Hey, it's going all right.
Well, you know,
I'm a little sick today, but...
You're sick?
Yeah, a little bit.
Oh, that's no good. That's because you live in the frozen tundra.
Yeah, I know.
There's no sickness when it's 80.
And I'm hungover a little bit too, so...
Well, that's good for you. I'm not hungover because all I had was sparkling grape juice last night with my pregnant wife and two kids. So that was my freaking New Year's Eve party. I didn't even have a beer. So, yeah, there you go. So,
there you go.
You had a winning season this season. How do you feel about your season as a whole in 2016?
It could have been worse. I mean, I made a little run there at the end, but it was, I had some injuries. I didn't have enough good players to back up my injuries I had. And, I don't know. I did pick up a few good players, and I don't know. I felt like I did okay, a lot better than last year, so.
No, I thought it was solid. I didn't think you did bad. It was okay, for sure.
Yeah, and I mean, I lost a lot of close games. I lost a lot of close games, too, so. I was right there. I mean, I only had like one game under 100, I think.
Hey, you finished with a winning record. I mean, that's solid.
Yeah.
So, I mean, yeah. That's all you, that's all you.
You're cutting in and out a lot, man.
Am I? How's that?
Huh?
That better?
Yeah, that's better.
Okay. So, when you're looking at your 2017 draft next year, obviously it's going to be the team that builds Cheesehead for the future. What do you look at in your first round pick? Are you looking quarterback? You looking running back? Who's the first piece of the puzzle?
Probably a running back, I guess, depending on what I pick. But I'd like to get a solid running back. If I pick early, I'm going to look for a solid running back. If I pick late, I'll see what's on the board, I guess. It'll probably be a wide receiver or a running back.
Wide receiver or running back. Interesting.
Or maybe a quarterback. I might go with quarterback, too.
Interesting. Okay.
I don't know. I guess I'm just going to kind of play it by ear on, or, you know, see how the draft's going. I'm hoping to get an early spot.
Yeah.
So we'll see how it goes.
Well, it's gonna be interesting. We're gonna have a live draft lottery, so we'll have a live show where we draft. We'll pick it live, so everybody will know. Everybody's gonna have the same opportunity to be the first overall pick. So that should be cool. So you've who are you picking to win today's game? Hardcore Bowl 8. Who do you?
I'm gonna have to go with Tom, but. You know, I would like to see Matt win it, but I mean I was looking at the lineups and I just with Le'Veon Bell out, and I mean he did pick up Drone, which Hyde is hurt and on injured reserve, but I mean I just think he outdoes him on too many positions. I do think Matt will, the receivers. His receivers are better than Tom's, but I think quarterback, Tom has them, and I think running backs, Tom has them too. But those are the big ones. So
I agree. Yeah. I think the wide receivers are the big question mark for Matt. If his wide receivers can blow up today, I think that would be huge. But so far, yeah, it's the first quarter, and Tom Brady has 15 points already, and he's driving the ball again. So that's not looking good for Matt early.
No.
It's not looking good early. Yeah. It's not looking good early.
It sucks that they had to, set Le'Veon Bell out. I mean, that's what happens. I mean, it's part of it, but I feel bad for him that they had to set him out. You know, that's his main core right there. So.
Yeah, that's a bummer. That's a bummer, but that's fantasy football. So, all right, tonight, let's switch gears, Corey. Let's switch gears. Let's go from fantasy football to the NFL. Tonight's a huge game. What do you got to say about tonight's game?
I think it'll be a tough game because it's on the road and it's a division matchup. It's going to be a tough game, but I think, the way the Packers have been playing, if they continue to play that way, I think they'll win. I mean, and I think the Lions, but they haven't been playing well, so I don't know. I mean, as long as they show up like they have been, I think the Packers will win that game. I mean, but I think it'll be a tight game, within a touchdown. So,
are you predicting a Packers victory tonight?
I am. Of course, I am.
Hell yes.
But, I mean, even if I wasn't a Packers fan, if I was just picking with my brain and not my heart, I would still pick the Packers. I mean, they've won five in a row, and working on. So, I mean, it's hard to go against somebody that's that hot.
Oh,
and then the Lions, I think, have lost two in a row. I think, or they lost. No, they lost the last one, and then they almost won. They almost lost the one before against the Bears, I think.
Beaver Street Roar is closing the gap a little. It's 28-12. They got some points there, so I had to give them a little power up there. So they're closing the gap a little. They're closing the gap.
Yeah, Matt's never won it, has he?
No, Matt has never won it. He's never been there before. He's only got one previous playoff victory. So this would be
That's why I was hoping that he could win. Tom's in there every year.
It seems like it.
Yeah, it is. I mean, he's right up there. He's in the playoffs every year, I think.
So. Oh yeah, he's been in the playoffs every year since he's been in the league. This is his.
That's a pretty amazing accomplishment.
This is his.
I can't seem to get there at all.
Yeah, this is his seventh straight playoff appearance. That's crazy.
Yeah,
that's insane, man.
I do feel like I'm more experienced now. I mean, when I first drafted, because we're a dynasty kind of a league. I was only like my second year ever playing at any kind of fantasy, and I was pretty new to it. So I feel like I'll do better in my draft than I did the first time or first go around. So
yeah, I think this draft is going to be real interesting. I'm freaking excited about this draft. I can get a chance to completely build a whole new team from scratch. I plan on. My first five picks are basically my freaking five keepers to go on to the future. That's how I'm looking at these picks. And
yeah, me too.
It's a different kind of draft. Not just looking at one season. I'm trying to draft these guys so I don't have to fill those holes for seasons to come.
Right. So, you don't want to draft a 40-year-old.
No. Hell no.
Yeah, no. I know. Yeah, I was thinking the same thing too.
Yeah.
I was looking into that. So.
It's going to make this draft fun.
It'll be interesting, and you'll have more players to pick from, so that'll be, you only got 16 in here.
Yep.
So that's going to be nice, too.
Yeah, it's going to be fun. Well, thanks for joining us, Corey. Take some time out. Hope you feel better. Happy New Year.
Yeah.
Happy New Year.
Yeah, Happy New Year to you.
And hopefully your Packers win tonight, although I don't really care either way, but I just want the Raiders to win today. That's all I care about, what happens today. So, alrighty, there we go. We had Corey Courtney, owner of Cheesehead, on with us. He's also picking RBs. Everybody that we've had on the phone thus far has picked RBs. So for myself, who picked the Beaver Street Roar, rolling Dirty South, representing. Trying to take it down, but right now, it is 31-12. RBs over the Beaver Street Roar as they're stretching the lead. Tom Brady's already got 16 points. Still has the ball. Let's see who's going to be. Somebody's got to put it in the paint for the Beaver Street Roar. He's got to get a touchdown. He's got to get a touchdown. Somebody from the Beaver Street Roar's got to put it in the paint. Desperately needs to get a score. Desperately needs to get a score. Cam Newton with 60 passing yards thus far has only warranted him 3 points. As across the way, he's got 16 going for Tom Brady already. Tom Brady still got the ball. 17-0 lead for the Pats. So they are putting the boots right now to the fish, which is what I would have predicted anyway. I don't think the Dolphins are as good as their record says they are. But that's just my opinion. So, somebody needs to step it up for the Beaver Street Roar. Who's it going to be? It's 31-12 currently. 31-12. Who is going to be the guy who gets it done for the Beaver Street Roar? Going into the second quarter now in New England. Or excuse me, in Miami with New England. Also going into the second quarter is Cam Newton as the first quarter's wrapping up. They're maintaining. Currently on the field right now, you only have Alexander. For Buffalo, linebacker for Buffalo, flex defensive player for RBs, and Wallace, wide receiver for the Beaver Street Roar. They're the only players currently this second on the field ready to go. And they are off the field. Second quarter starting up for almost all of the games. All the games are in the second quarter now. All the early games. It's now a 20-point lead for RBs. They opened it up to 20 for the first time. Line projections has RBs at 149, has Beaver Street Roar at 106. They are not projecting a big game for the Beaver Street Roar, the NFL.com line graph. Not that that means anything necessarily, but it could. Send him in. So it's 33-12. Opened up to a 21-point lead. So, joining us next, we have our first ever in studio guest. He's rocking his salute to service Khalil Mack jersey, ready for the game today. We have my son, Mr. Craven Lane Klein. How are you doing today, buddy? You ready for, speak up, okay? You ready for the Raiders game today?
Yeah.
Do you think we're going to beat the Broncos today?
Yes.
Do you think we're going to win the division today?
Yes.
All right. How do you feel that Matt McGloin is going to be able to fill the hole that we need with Derek Carr going down. You think he's going to do all right today?
Maybe.
Maybe? You think? You think he's going to have trouble today?
Possibly, yes.
Possibly, yes? Well, I can see that. I can see that. I mean, they got a tough defense. We're going against a tough defense. McGloin hasn't started all season, so it's going to be tough. I know you're going to be watching today, though, right?
Yeah.
All right. As you see, he's rocking his Khalil Mack jersey, his new Khalil Mack jersey he got for Christmas. So he's expecting a big game out of Khalil Mack. So who is your favorite Raiders player that's playing right now?
Probably Crabtree.
Crabtree's your favorite player that's playing right now. Who's your favorite defensive player?
Mack.
Khalil Mack? Crabtree. Who's your second favorite offensive player?
That's playing today.
Well, no, that's just playing. That's on the team.
Oh, okay. Carr.
Carr. He's your probably favorite player overall, isn't
he? No,
it?
He's my second.
He's your second? Crabtree's your favorite?
Yeah.
Ooh, he likes Crabtree. He likes Crabtree. Okay. Well, I guess we'll see if they win today, buddy.
Okay.
All right. Thanks for joining us, bud. It's our first in-studio guest, Mr. Craven Lane. Give us some insight on what he thinks is going to go on. So, I'm going to pause. I'm going to take a quick break. We'll reboot and be right back on. Hardcore Bowl 8. Stay tuned.